This video tutorial is provided by the College of Graduate Studies at UCF. In this video, I will review the requirements for formatting tables, provide an example of what a properly formatted table looks like, and demonstrate how to implement these settings in an existing ETD. Tables should be placed within a document as close as possible to the text referring to them, or collected within an appendix. However, a table should not interrupt a line of text. If a table does not fit on the page containing the body text referring to it, you may place it on the next page. If a table does not fit on one page, whether in portrait or landscape orientation, or within a custom page size, you may break it over the page. If you break the table over pages, repeat the header row for each page. Do not repeat the title or mark the table as continued. I'll show you an example of a formatted table within the sample ETD, which is available on the College of Graduate Studies website. From the list of tables, there is a link to Table 1. The title is placed above the table, with the label and number of the table aligned with the left margin. The source notes are placed below the table and are single-spaced as table text. There is adequate and consistent spacing separating the table from the body text. I'll show you how to use the caption style to create a linked and auto-numbered table. As it is not always practical to recreate tables in Word, this tutorial will also demonstrate how to insert a previously made table from Microsoft Excel. I will also cover how to create a table in Word. To insert the table, I'm going to highlight my table in Excel, copy it, and then return to my Word document. With the cursor placed where I want the table to appear, I will choose the Paste option from the Home tab and choose Paste Special. Word gives me the option to paste an Excel object. This way, I can edit the table if need be, without making the changes in Excel and reinserting it into the document. If you wish to draw your table through Word, go to the Insert tab and click Table. From this menu, you can select the number of rows and columns and insert them within the document. Regardless of whether you have inserted a table through Excel or Word, click the table you have inserted and go to the References tab of the ribbon. Select Insert Caption. The caption should read Table 1. If it does not use the table label, go to the Options section and under Label, select Table from the drop-down menu. Change the position to Above Selected Item. By using the word heading styles, Word is able to recognize that this is my first table in the document. Click OK. You should see a caption appear at the top of the table. You can place the cursor after the number of the table and type the table title. By inserting a caption, Word has generated the caption style. The caption style will also automatically keep track of which table is which number and keep them in sequential order. You can see that when I insert a caption above this one, it automatically renumbers them. This also allows Word to automatically generate the list of tables. To update the table caption, you can right-click the number and use the Update Field option from the Editing menu. You can now go to the Home tab and select the Caption Style from the Styles menu. Right-click the style and choose Modify from the Editing menu. Because it is based on Normal, it should retain the font choice used for the body text. However, it may be in a different color and font size. You may change the font size to between 10 and 12 point. If you choose to use a color for captions, be sure to use the same color for all table and figure captions. You can also change the line spacing to single space for table text and titles. Click OK to return to the document. If you need to place notes below the table, do not use the caption style for notes or sources. You can create a style specifically for notes, or you may simply apply the normal style to the note text. Place your cursor below the table and type the notes using the same font as the body text of your document. If you need to break a table across the page, you will need to repeat the header row. Because Excel tables are inserted as objects, these tables will not break across the page. If you need it to continue onto multiple pages, you will need to create multiple objects from your table in Excel, with each object containing the header row. Then reinsert these tables into Word. With a table created in Word, you can format the table to repeat the header row automatically. Right-click the table and select Table Properties. Click the Rows tab. You can use the Next Row and Previous Row buttons to select the appropriate header row. You should see the option to repeat as header row at the top of each page. Check this box to repeat the header row and continue the table. If the table does not fit on the page, you can also go to the Page Layout menu and change the page orientation to Landscape. You can view the video tutorial on page orientation to see how I use section breaks to turn one page to landscape while keeping the rest of the document in portrait. This concludes the video tutorial for tables. If you have any further questions, please use the ETD help request form available through the Thesis and Dissertation Services website. In the next video, I will discuss how to format figures.